This puzzle is sold as a Dayan 16-axis hexadecagon. That name is kind of completely wrong, but anyway. It consists of four hexagons, there, 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 and there, and 12 pentagons. The movement on the hexagons is very good, very smooth. The movement on the pentagons is a bit, little bit catchy. The hexagons are slightly pillowed, and I think, yeah, the pentagons are flat. The correct name for the shape is truncated triacus tetrahedron. That's truncated triacus tetrahedron. Comes out of the box a little bit greasy, so it's been sort of a bit over-lubed. Now, the movement is a little bit strange. It's almost like a tutmix, really. Because obviously, like, each side you can go to any place you want. But if you're going to make... when you make secondary moves... because if you like, look at that... the pentagon, you've got, like, quite a large edges there. And then smaller ones. So it's not symmetrical. So... if you want to put one of these edges into like a hexagon side, it has to come from a hexagon side. So I can put that one in and then I can continue moving. If however I tried to put one of the ones from like a pentagon side, it won't move. Now there is a danger, I guess, that it could be forced into place, which I won't do. Because, I mean, that happened on the tutmix. So if you start forcing it into place, then you can get lockups and it's a real pain. But if you're using it properly, you know, you shouldn't be doing that. Now, because of this situation, it means it jumbles. Because, like, now I can, even though I've gone to there, I can still move this one because it's like a pentagon. So I can continue scrambling, but that side of things is blocked. So, and that'll become more and more blocked. So that, you know, makes it really difficult to actually solve those sort of puzzles. And it does also mean, obviously, it shapeshifts, but only in a very kind of minor way. It's always going to look kind of ball shape. So, let's scramble it carefully so I don't do any illegal moves. I'm guessing perhaps it would be a good idea to really concentrate on... oh, maybe not. I'm finding it kind of hard to make any additional moves very early on. Yeah, if I just mix some pentagon and pentagon pieces, maybe that's kind of the way to scramble it. Oh, I said, but I'm not a fan of jumbling puzzles. I just think they're a bit of a pain. I was kind of hoping it would be more like a Megaminx, because it looks like a Megaminx a little bit. I think actually the pentagons aren't perfect pentagons because of the thick bits. I think they're a little bit lopsided, which you can't really see looking down on them. But I think if you took accurate measurements, you'd find they weren't perfect pentagons. It's so tempting to make an illegal move, but I'll try not to. Okay, so I think I'm going to leave it at that, because I really can't be bothered to go any further with it. But obviously, it would, you know, with a bit of time you could scramble it. Now what I will do is take a look inside it. Now because it's a bit greasy, I don't want to get this surface greasy, so let's find something to put it on. As usual, I'm just going to kind of sticking a screwdriver into an edge and see what happens. Yes, that comes out pretty easily. Right, so that's the core within a core kind of thing. So, and that is as far as I'm going to go. At the beginning, I said it was kind of greasy. I mean, it was okay, it was usable, but because by taking it apart, I'm pretty much making everything greasy now. And when I assemble it, the whole thing's going to be sort of horrible and greasy. So if you don't want that situation, don't disassemble it. But I mean, I want to do projects, you know, I want to use puzzles for projects and stuff, so I want to be able to take them apart and not have them greasy. So the way to degrease a puzzle like this is to pour on some warm water, a bit of fairy liquid or washing up, any sort of washing up liquid. Because the problem of doing this is the pieces are hollow, so the water's going to go inside. So you really can't be any rush to use it. Right, so I'm going to rinse this in a sink, dry the pieces as best as I can with a towel, and then I'm going to lay them out somewhere in a warm place, and sort of over the next few hours or so, that should sort of dry.